My job has been to break into computer systems for 25 years now. We call it penetration testing in the security industry. Kind of a dirty word, but so basically that's been the focus of my career, you know? And I've been recently in the last 7 years working a lot with Hollywood and the music industry. So I've been involved in the making of a number of different movies. Well, the truth is we're very vulnerable. And with there's this misconception that by throwing money at it or throwing technology at this problem that it's going to fix it, and that's not true. This concept of protection, the best way to put it is it's a fallacy. It's not true. We can't really protect ourselves the way that we think. If you think about it in physical terms, you know, what can you do to protect yourself physically is go take some karate classes, go learn some judo, whatever. But not everybody can do that. But everybody carries a phone, everybody carries the technology, but is not in a position to protect themselves, right? Companies are no different. They're just people too who work there. So the truth is it's not really about protection. It's more a matter of being able to operate even under a hack, right? So WannaCry was a good example of just how bad the impact can be. And so it's not about hacking, it's more about disaster recovery, you know? You have to be able to operate even under these type of attacks happening, because they will continue to happen, and no matter how much money and resources we throw at it, it isn't gonna really make that big of a difference. It'll continue to happen. You know, hacking as we know it is very, very much a matter of financial gain now. You know, the motive used to be just to see if you can make it work or not work. And, the motives were very different when I got started. Now the motives are entirely financial gain. So healthcare, when attackers figure out how to monetize healthcare data, they'll become an even bigger target. Right now they're just low-hanging fruit because they don't spend the kind of money that, say, intelligence agencies do on security or government agencies do. So, and they don't have the resources. That's the biggest problem, is not the technology, it's the people. We have a massive shortage of qualified people in this space. There hasn't been any kind of disruptive technology for consumers since the antivirus, which is now 20 years old. And there is no viruses, nobody writes viruses, nobody's destroying data, they're trying to steal data, they're trying to monetize data. So there hasn't been anything, really, if you really look around, there's a lot of tools for people like me to use, but it's in terminology that you would never understand and you wouldn't even know how to set it up. So the focus of Seguru is to provide people with what's in our heads in software. So through infrastructure, through software, and through hardware, be able to provide people on their mobile devices, initially only mobile, but because our lives run on it. There's a digital identity that you carry and that you that makes more of your world work than your physical identity does these days. So Seguru is focused on basically that. It's sort of in a very intelligent way educating you while you're using your device about what your device is doing. Right now you can't even tell what your device is doing. So. I always use the analogy of the microwave. Everybody seems to know you put some food in there, hit some buttons, and makes food warm. And it's not really important for you to know how I got the food warm. But this is a device that we use that our life depends on, that you really need to know a little bit more about what's going on inside that device and what it's doing and how it can impact you. Not so much with other technology like a microwave. So, some people care more, some people don't care so much. I think, there's a lot of arguments to be made. Some people just go, I'm not doing anything, I don't really care. But the truth is, you're giving your information every day to all kinds of different organizations. You hit yes before you read any of that stuff, and even if you read it, you probably wouldn't hit no, because then you can't use these services. So there's no such thing as free. Every free service is monetizing you in some way or another, and that's fine, because there is value. But I think that there is a level of awareness that we need to raise within consumers without making it another boring technical thing, you know? Don't entirely trust the technology. I think we're too trusting of the technology. So as I'll show here, we trust technology way too much, and it's very easy to manipulate that technology and ultimately manipulate you. So just watch out for the things that don't make sense. Don't believe what you see.